Okay, if you would please give them your undivided attention. What we're gonna work through right now is how to build the nail puzzle project in Fusion 360. So we're also recording this, so you can't crinkle in the background. It has to be absolutely silent, but so you'll be able to go back and refer to it. Okay, if you would.
Okay, so we're gonna start off with just a sketch. I normally like to do a sketch on this plane right here. Basically, we're going to start off with a center point rectangle. We're going to pull that out. So 2 tab 4.25. So there's our rectangle. Now, the easiest way I think to do this would be to make this come over and put it at 75 or 0.75 inches and then get one of these 2-point rectangles and grab that there and pull it down to there and then one. And then there's that. So now I'd come from this angle and come over 0.75 and do the exact same thing on this side. And then after this is all done, we're going to pull this out into a 3D part.
Nice and slow. Nice and slow. So we're all in sketch mode right here. We're all done sketching. It is contained, okay?
So that's our part right there. So we're going to take... stop sketch. Now, if I click, there's that part right there. So now I'm going to grab the extrude tool, which is located right here. Grab that face and pull it out to 0.75. And that, let me turn off the upgrade. So there's the part right there. Now the next thing we're going to do is we're going to create a sketch on that page. At that piece right there so that we can make our hole through the middle. And we're going to take a line and find the center point so you can move it along until it snaps to the center point and drag that down 0.5. And then come over here to sketch and get a center diameter circle. Place it on that point right there and then it is 0.4 centimeters. And that's our hole. So now if I click stop sketch, our hole's right there, and then I can click extrude and pull that through, and now we should have a hole going through both sides. Now we're going to get into the nail, which is a little bit more difficult because it uses a lot of different tools. So basically you want to use this plane right here, which is called an offset plane, and you're going to pull it through until it gets about to the center or close to the center.
Oh, I'm sorry, can I interrupt you? Can we go back one step? Yeah. How did you create that offset plane in the first case?
Okay, so right here, right above the construct down tab is offset plane. You basically choose a piece, and then it turns up, makes a plane there, and then you can pull that plane out to wherever you need to get a plane somewhere else. So then we're going to click OK, and we're going to create a new sketch on that plane. So basically that just divided and made a piece directly in the middle. So now I can grab a center point circle, and if I put it here and I pull it out, this is the hole that is drilled through the wooden block. So to make the nail, we're just going to make it just a little bit smaller than that hole and stop it there. Now I can pull that out to there. So now I'm going to extrude the nail out as a different part. So I'm going to turn off the body, get the extrude tool, pick that circle, and turn it back on. And then I'm going to come over here to one-sided. So instead of having it just go out this way, I'm going to have it go out both sides symmetrically. So now if I pull on this side, it comes out on both. So there's the nail. And now to make the head of the nail, we're going to make a new sketch on that piece right there. Take a circle, find that center point, which is right there, pull it out just a little bit bigger. Okay. And then we have that circle there. So now I'm going to extrude out that little circle there off the end of the nail to get the head of the nail. And then you can put on some fillets to make it look more like the end of a nail. just to give it a little bit of a curve. And now we're going to get onto the point, which is the final piece of this. So we're going to use the offset plane again, and we're going to offset it off the end of the shaft of the nail. Bring it out just a little bit and click OK. Now a new sketch on the plane. We're going to make a circle. And since we want this to be extremely pointy, this might not be the best way to do it, but this is the way that I would do it, is 0.01. And that makes a tiny, very tiny little circle right there that's almost like a point. So that right there is our point. And we're going to use a tool called Loft, which basically takes two shapes and makes a new shape that will combine the two, like that picture shows right there. So we're going to loft from the circle to the point, which is going to make that cone. And we have, and then we're going to color it now. So appearance. So basically I just right click off the part and click appearance, which is the one with the little colors. And we're going to come down here to wood, finished, oak, and put it right onto that.
Are you drag and drop?
Yeah. So it's a drag and drop. So I'd click it and I bring it out here and drop it onto there. And then you can also choose to do bodies and components or just the face of the part. Like, let's say you were painting that piece red. I could come and find a red paint, turn on faces, and just make one side red. So it kind of depends what you're doing, but that's basically a brief overview of some of the tools you can use in Fusion.
Could you go through first, how you save this file?
Sure.
And then secondly, how you create a working drawing?
Okay. So you're going to come up here to save, which is just a little save icon, and then you're going to name it. So okay, and then you just click save. And then if I'm correct, you just click from model to drawing from design. And you click OK. And then you can drop that in there. And then you come to this, and you click that, and you pull it down.
Up.
And then you can do a top view.
Yep.
And then you can also drag it out here and put the one in the corner like that. Oh, shoot.
I think right click. Okay.
All right. So then there's that.
And then if you want a dimensioning tool up above, so you can put dimensions on there. And then the other tool is the text tool, so you can fill in your title block, so you can put your scale in. That's B size paper. So you can type inches on that or title block, and then you drag it down into the title block. That was absolutely beautiful. This is, again, your working drawing. This working drawing is the one that goes into your portfolio.
Oh, and then if you wanted to change the paper, and correct it. Huh.
Double-click on that, on the sheet. Actually, on the pull-down menu on the sheet.
This one?
Oh, that's the access key.
Yeah, it's bodies. I don't remember.
Double-click on that. Like, up on the sheet type.
Oh, sheet type.
Maybe on the icon of it. Oh, that's good.
Huh.
Yeah.
That's strange.
So good.